Do you know about radon?
My dad was Richard Williams. He was a very prominent urologist. He was a very smart man. He was very well educated. He was top of his field. And still, radon came in and took him away from us. He'd worked so hard his whole life as a physician to be with his patients. And he was just getting to the part where he could relax and be with his family, and we missed that. Mom and I were looking through all the lung cancer causes and trying to understand why my dad would get lung cancer. And we saw radon, and I think that moment we kind of went, well, what's radon? And tried to figure out more about that. And that's when we discovered that there was a very inexpensive, easy test we could purchase to find out more about the levels in our home. We went to a local hardware store and picked up a home radon kit and put it in the basement to get the results. That was when we found out that we had very high levels in my parents' home. It was registering at about 18. So we knew we were in a danger zone, and the email was very clear that we needed to have some more testing done. So we contacted a radon professional in the Iowa area and had them come, and they placed machines around the house for, I think it was about 5 days. And when those levels came back, the basement was a 16, the main floor was an 8, and my parents' bedroom upstairs was 9.5. This house is 25 years old. It is very well maintained. My parents have put time and money into making sure it's the best that it can be for them to enjoy. And there's no reason that this house should have it any more than any others. I think when you think there's something wrong with your house, you think it's an old, decaying, yucky basement. Well, their basement isn't an old, decaying, yucky basement. It's well-maintained. And if your house is beautiful, if your house is not beautiful, there's nothing that radon knows. It is just a gas from the ground, and it can be anywhere. It just needed a simple venting procedure to get the radon out. When we first started talking to family members, everybody said, oh yeah, I have that monitor in my house. And immediately we knew they were talking about a CO2 monitor and that they didn't know what radon was. And we even thought the same thing at first, so we've taken care of that. But I think really radon is so unknown. People don't understand that there isn't a plug-in device to put in your house. It's not that simple. It's a simple test to do, but we don't have these in our houses already. I think if I could have one message for my dad, it would be to go get the test. It costs less than going to Starbucks and getting two drinks for two people, to go and get a test and put it in your basement or your lower level and find out if you have radon in your house. We talked about the fact that he said, if this is why I have lung cancer from radon, then I want to blow this, you know, out of the water. I don't think he had enough time to be able to take the message as far as he would like to. I think it progressed so quickly that he wasn't able to do that. His biggest legacy in his death through lung cancer would be to make sure that people are getting their homes tested. I would love if the medical profession could help everybody with this. I know when I go to my pediatrician's office with my children, there's tons of signs on the door about carbon monoxide or poison control or so many different things that I need to follow up on, but I've never seen anything about radon. So it's very important to me for the doctors and nurses to be able to tell us or give us an idea that it is something we need to look into, it is something we need to follow up on at our own homes so that we can be keeping our families safe. I would like you as medical professionals to encourage your patients to get the test. We don't know everything there is to know yet. We're still learning, but we can start with this test.
It's odorless, tasteless, and colorless. There are no sensory reminders to alert us to its presence. Radon is a radioactive gas, a silent killer, which is seeping into homes and workplaces across this nation. Radon gas is a radioactive decay product of radium. Radium occurs naturally below the Earth's surface in soil, rock, and water. As radium decays, it produces radon gas, which collects in soil and groundwater. Radon, in turn, decays through alpha particle emission. Alpha particles generally do not penetrate through the dead layer of the skin, so it is not considered an external radiation exposure hazard. However, radon decays into a series of solid radioactive decay products that can remain unattached in the air or attached to existing aerosols or other airborne particles. Depending on the size of the particles, the decay products, and the attachment rate, the particles can be inhaled and deposited in the lung on the respiratory epithelium. Once inhaled, two of the radon decay products, polonium-218 and polonium-214, undergo further alpha decay and impart the greatest radiation dose to the inner lining of the lung. Because buildings are not generally built radon resistant, radon tends to concentrate indoors. Radon has been found in various concentration levels nationwide. It generally enters at the lowest level of the building and can move into other areas, especially when the building is heated or cooled using forced air. All buildings can potentially have elevated concentrations of radon, even new constructions. Radon enters buildings through cracks in foundation walls and floors, as well as spaces around conduits and pipes. Even use of groundwater can contribute to indoor radon levels. The National Research Council's Committee on the Biological Effects of Ionizing Radiation at the National Academy of Science has documented the positive dose-response findings of lung cancer risk based on 11 large-scale studies of radon-exposed underground miners. Their findings indicated that radon is a potent occupational carcinogen and concluded that new cases of lung cancer are greatly increased by radon exposure to the general population. The EPA estimates that radon is responsible for over 21,000 lung cancer deaths each year in the United States. Direct evidence from combined or pooled residential radon studies performed in North America, China, and Europe supports the EPA's mortality estimates. It is an underappreciated fact that radon exposure is the second leading cause of lung cancer and the leading cause of lung cancer in individuals who have never smoked. Most radon-induced lung cancers occur from protracted exposure to low and medium radon concentrations. In the United States, radon is the leading environmental cause of cancer mortality and the seventh leading cause of cancer mortality overall. As physicians and healthcare providers, we should all become proactive in the fight against radon and the efforts to get the word out. We must join the front lines of this battle to reduce cancer. Our best defense against radon-related lung cancer is to raise public awareness and knowledge. Educating patients about the risks and promoting the use of radon test kits is something everyone can do and should do. As a healthcare provider, you are in a position to help spread the word that researchers have found elevated levels of radon in all 50 states and throughout Canada. It is estimated that high levels of radon can be found in as many as 1 in 15 homes across our nation. And people won't know if they have significant or actionable levels of radon where they live or work unless they test. Test kits are simple to use, inexpensive, and widely available. Kits can often be found in local hardware stores, county extension offices, and even ordered over the internet. There are basically two types of test kits available. Short-term kits are single-use. They work by sampling the air in the environment over several days. Placed in a basement, crawl space, or other suspect areas, they trap radon particles from the air into charcoal containers. That container is then sealed and mailed to a laboratory for analysis. The cost to purchase these kits is minimal, and it often includes the cost of a certified laboratory's evaluation and delivery of the results. The second type is a long-term radon detector that is placed in the home for 1 year. The long-term tests are available for purchase in the same locations as short-term tests. They are designed to sample levels of radon over extended periods of time. When the lab report arrives, numbers will clearly state the levels of radon found in the sampled area. Understanding the numbers on the report is important. They will tell you if you need to take action or simply test again in a few years. Radon levels are shown as a number of picocuries per liter. Studies have shown that in the United States, our average outdoor levels are 0.4 picocuries per liter, and indoor levels average about 1.3 picocuries per liter. While the EPA's current take action level is 4 picocuries per liter, they remind you that radon is a radioactive gas and suggest you may want to consider mitigating procedures with levels between 2 and 4 picocuries per liter. The World Health Organization currently recommends 3 picocuries per liter as a worldwide guideline. If test results demonstrate elevated levels of radon, we recommend taking action as quickly as possible to have a mitigation system installed. Often certified professionals only need a day in your home to seal cracks and install a radon mitigation system that lowers levels of radon by venting it safely outside. Because there are so many variables involved, it is difficult to predict the costs, but many people find the cost is similar to a basic home repair job, and professionals will provide estimates in advance of performing the work. Remember, the risk of radon-associated lung cancer is reduced as quickly as a mitigation system is in place. Act now. Test your home and educate your patients, families, and friends. You never know whose life you may be saving. I've tested my home in the past and found the radon levels were normal. I retested a couple years ago and found they had risen to 6 picocuries per liter. I immediately contacted a certified professional and had them install a radon mitigation system. Overnight, the radon levels went from 6 picocuries per liter to 0.6 picocuries per liter. My family and I now breathe easier.